Hi and welcome to another Oxmond tutorial. Let's take a look at how we change the sprite image by code. First of all, we need some sprite graphics. Go to the Unity Asset Store. Search for 2D Sprites Pack or just use the direct link in the description. Click Import and select the bird and the dead bird and some background. Here we go. Unity just created a sprite folder, and if we take a look at that, we can see our brand new sprites inside. Let's rename the sprite. We call the background for background, and the bird we just call bird, and the dead bird we just call bird dead. Drag the background into the scene. It's a little bit too big, so we just scale it to 1.5 and 1.5. Bird time. Drag the bird into the scene. It's a little bit small and heading in the wrong direction. Let's fix that. Change the X scale to -1.5. And the Y scale we change to 1.5 as well. Let's have a look. Looks fine. Now it's time for some scripting. Go to the asset folder and create a new C# script. We could call it just bird. Remember to drag the bird script to the bird sprite. And we click on the bird sprite to actually make sure that the script is attached. Looks fine. Double click on the bird sprite to open Visual Studio. We don't need the first part of the script, so just delete it. To make the bird fall, we use the transform translate command. Type transform.translate. Translate. And now we have to type the values of the direction of the bird. This could be something like 0 and -0.25. And the C value is always 0 when it's 2D. Finish the line with semicolon and click save. Let's go back to Unity and see how it works. Ah, nice. Working perfect. Now, let's present the bird dies when it reaches the end of the screen. We have to find the Y value for that position. Copy that value and move the bird up again. The bird should only fall when it's inside the screen. So we will make an if statement for that. Something like this. If transform.position.y is less or equals to -4. Then move the bird. We already have the line for that, so we just move it up here. Back to Unity, let's see how it goes. Nah, not that good. My bad, it has to be larger or equals to. Let's test again. So much better. And now for the change image trick. We would like to change the image when the bird reads the end of the screen. We can just use a simple else statement for that. To actually change the sprite, we will write something like this. This.gameObject.getComponent sprite renderer dot sprite equals to dead bird semicolon. Dead bird is a variable, so we will create that in the top of the script. Public sprite dead bird semicolon. And we can just click on it to make sure there's no typos. Back in Unity, now drag the bird dead sprite to the bird value in the script. Let's test. Beautiful. That was it. We are done for today. Please like and subscribe for more Unity tutorials. Have a nice day.